Good morning and welcome to prayer and devotion on this Thursday. Today is Thursday, March 7th, and it is good to be with all of you this morning, holding each one of you in prayer as we begin this day. That was Change My Heart, O God by Maranatha Praise Band off of their Top 40 Christian Favorites album. So if you enjoyed that, you can look that up. That was a nice, I've not heard that rendition, so. Today, we are looking at Philippians 4, looking at verses 10 and 11, no, 11 and 12, Philippians 4, 11 and 12, and we're going to be talking about a converted life, so we're going to be talking about change. So, I'm glad you're here, praying for each one of you as we begin this day. My name is Cindy Stauffer. I'm blessed to serve as the pastor at the United Methodist Church at New Brunswick. And this is a recorded devotion today because I am at the Board of Ordained Ministry retreat. So if you are praying for us, keep praying for us. This is our day of discernment as we will make decisions seeking God's wisdom for the candidates that have come up and we've interviewed. So just keep us all in prayer. I'm glad you're with us today and know that you are held in prayer as well. So let's take a look. Philippians 4, verses 11 and 12. I might read 13 too. Why not? Because it's one of my favorite. So Philippians 4:11. Not that I am referring to being in need, for what I have learned, for I have learned to be content in whatever I have. I know what it is to have little, and I know what it is to have plenty. In any and all circumstances, I have learned the secret of being well-fed and of going hungry, of having plenty and of being in need. I can do all things through Him who strengthens me. So today's devotion is another daily meditation from Henry Nouwen. This one came in on March 3rd, and it is entitled A Converted Life, A Converted Life. Living a spiritual life requires a change of heart, a conversion. Such a conversion may be marked by a sudden inner change, or it can take place through a long, quiet process of transformation. But it always involves an inner experience of oneness. We realize that we are in the center and that from there, all that is and all that takes place can be seen and understood as a part of the mystery of God's life with us. Our conflicts and pains, our tasks and promises, our families and friends, our activities and projects, our hopes and aspirations no longer appear to us as fatiguing variety of things that we can barely keep together, but rather as affirmations and revelations of the new life of the Spirit in us. All these other things which so occupied and preoccupied us now come as gifts or challenges that strengthen and deepen the new life that we have discovered. This does not mean that the spiritual life makes things easier or takes our struggles and pains away. The lives of Jesus' disciples clearly show that suffering does not diminish because of conversion. Sometimes it even becomes more intense. But our attention is no longer directed to the more or less. What matters is to listen attentively to the Spirit and go obediently where we are being led, whether to a joyful or a painful place. Poverty, pain, struggle, anguish, agony, and even inner darkness may be a part of our experience. They may even be God's way of purifying us. But life is no longer boring, resentful, depressing, or lonely because we have come to know that everything that happens is a part of our way to the Father, to God. Today I had the chance to talk with Pastor Joe, who's coming up to the board, and some of you know him. I ask that you keep him in prayer. But we were talking about this. We were talking about how even when we're called, even when God places a call on our lives, and God calls all of us, not just ministers or clergy people, God calls all of us. But when God puts a call on our lives, that doesn't mean that there aren't going to be challenges. I mean, of course, all we have to do is look at Jesus and look at the disciples and look at anyone who has followed Jesus to see that the challenges still arise. I mean, often they become more intense. That's what Henry Nouwen said today. And so what is different, right? Than our life before conversion. And the difference is that all of those challenges that we face now become an opportunity for God to either teach us something, purify or shape and mold us into something new, or some of those challenges will help us to be a part of God's salvation for someone else, right? I think about people who have walked through something really hard and they've seen God's hand in the midst of it, and they tell their story and someone else says, I've been through that. I know what that's like, and you got through it. So I trust that God will get me through this as well. Sometimes the challenges that we face, sometimes the trials that we have to walk through become not only a purifying, a remolding of us, but they become a way for God's love to reach out and touch someone else's life. Now we have the choice when we're going through something. We can complain and just feel bitter about it, feel like, how could God do this to me? That's not right. And that's real. I mean, all of us have said that at times. But if that's the only way that we can see the trials of our lives, as if somehow we're being punished, we may miss out on the real salvation that God is trying to offer, not only us, but someone else that will come along our journey, that will need to know, oh, God got you through that. Maybe God can get me through this as well. So, being called, we're all called, brings blessing and also brings challenges. But even in the midst of, I was today, as I was writing my journal, I was asking, like, what are the things that I need to learn? What are the new things that I will need to learn in this next journey of my life? What are the places that I'm still, I still need some, I've got challenges that I've got to face and deal with. What are those things? And how can I trust God more fully in them? So today, I invite you to look at what you're walking through and think about the people that have come along and helped you in your journey. Maybe there was someone that said, you know, I went through that. You're not alone. I know what you're walking through, and I'm going to be with you. God's going to be with you. Who are those people that have helped you in your journey? Yes, a couple days ago, I asked you to tell people, thank you for loving me. Well, maybe today you reach out and say, thank you. Thank you for walking with me and encouraging me and letting me know that I'm not alone. That's important. So as we come into this time of prayer, where is the call that God's been put on you? What is the call that God has put on your heart? And do you trust that no matter what you're walking through, God will lead you through to the place that God has called you to? Let's pray. God, thank you for calling us and loving us. Thank you for leading us through times of trial. Thank you for shaping and remolding us that we might be more faithful in our following. That we might, through our living and through our loving, offer something to those around us. Forgive us when we have grown bitter, unable to trust that you're in the midst of it all. Forgive us when we have chosen paths again and again that took us in an opposite direction. But Lord, thank you for leading us back. And thank you for placing a call on each of our hearts, seeing something good in each one of us, seeing possibility. Help us, Lord, to trust that call and to step out, even when it's hard, knowing that as we step out, you are already there. We ask all of this in your name, Lord Jesus, as together we pray the prayer that you taught your disciples. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us, and lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever. Amen. Praying for each one of you that you will know that no matter what you're walking through today, that you don't walk alone. God loves you, my friends, and so do I. I look forward, tomorrow will be live, Friday, I will be live with you, and I look forward to seeing you all then. Have a very blessed day. Bye, friends.